Hey, it's Jave and Andy from Two Dudes Reviews.
Yeah, pretty much. And today we are reviewing, it's an older album. It's been out since 2015. Maybe you have it, maybe you don't. If you're a rock partisan, you should have it. This is one of those, must-haves.
Must-haves.
In any rock collection.
It's a great album.
And this is the intro that we're doing for this particular video as we review Polyester Zeal from the rock band Red Sun Rising. Now we're back.
We're back. Jake can't figure out why I say we're back, but the reality is that you just saw some really cool graphics and stuff that went across the screen.
Now we're back.
And now we're back about to review this album.
Yeah, and so like I said, our plan is eventually to have new album premieres on our YouTube channel and
of course
review some brand new spanking stuff.
Don't we all want the newest, latest, greatest?
Pretty much, kind of, sort of. Yeah, of course. But today, we're reviewing this album just because Andy and I both know it, and we both really dig it, and we figure that we'd turn you on to it as well. Hi, Lo.
I'm just trying to figure out where I am in the camera there, so I'm not sitting over here going, hey, how's it going?
Polyester Zeal is the album from Red Sun Rising. First song is called Push. It's a rocker. It starts something like a this. And again. Is that loud enough for you, Andy?
Flipping great.
I feel like Wayne and Garth in Gotta Moosh, can you do the band? Thunderbolts of lightning. It's a dance song.
It's hard not to tap your toe. It
really
or
is.
Something to this.
I'm pouring a beer as we listen.
I'm just going to keep drinking.
I love it when a rock band puts out an album and it starts like this. Just right in your face. Boom, smack, dab, there, and a little dabble-doo.
Makes you want to drive fast.
It kind of does, man. It is a good driving song, is it not?
Absolutely.
Now, when I first got this album in the mail, and I was really intrigued by the first single called The Other Side, which we'll get to in just a second. But I put the whole album in. First song, I went, okay, great, straight-up rock song. And then this song, with this weird kind of guitar thing, freaked me out, and I went, man, the production on this is so incredibly cool, and I'll point out what I mean in just a second here. It's a great headphone song, so if you're watching our video and you have the access to headphones to listen to this on headphones, please do. It's called Amnesia. Check it out. Now, right there. It's weird. Have you seen the video for this particular song, Andy? Man,
I have not, or I might have.
It's very funny. We've seen it over at your place, but I think it was dark at the time.
It must have been dark.
It's kind of done as one of those infomercials where the guy is going, for the next 10 minutes,
oh, yeah,
you can get
Red Sun Rising. Oh, it is
for
so cool.
$6.99.
I remember that. And it's the ShamWow guy.
Yes. And that's actually the singer, Mike, who is the host of the infomercial
thing.
He's
playing the ShamWow guy.
He's playing the ShamWow guy. It's very funny. I'll try and do the link.
Today and today only.
That's right. We're blowing out all these copies of Red Sun Rising. Buy one. In fact, we'll give you two free. You can buy the whole seat, but you only need the edge. The edge. Sorry.
Leave it to the damn radio guy to mess with the knobs.
Sorry. All right, so there's Amnesia for you. Incredibly cool song. Now, the track that introduced us to the band. When I first heard this one, I went, oh, wow, a new Alice in Chains track. Partially because of the lyrics, or the vocal stylings, the harmonies, but also this weird guitar part.
And that drum intro.
And this guitar piece. Very Jerry Cantrell.
Through all your moments and tearing up memories.
man, what a chorus. 48 seconds into the damn song, and they're blowing it out. Again, another song that had a crazy video that scared the hell out of me the first time I saw it, where he's like literally just in mud in and out of the out of this video. Incredibly cool video. I'll try and post that link to that video up there, too. And if not, just do a search for The Other Side from Red Sun Rising. You'll find it. Okay. And by the way, the band is from Akron, Ohio.
Akron.
Akron, Ohio. I've only been to Columbus.
You always got to ask people who live there.
Yeah.
As to what the proper pronunciation is, right? So people say we live in Nevada.
Right.
We don't. We live in Nevada.
Nevada, man.
Right. Okay. It's Nevada, right?
This one's called My Muse. And I like the lyrical content of this because I come from a household of addicts. My father was a raging alcoholic. My brother was on his deathbed, literally. Paranoid, coke binge. It was horrible. He had a sawed-off shotgun to his head, hiding out in a closet, thinking the Mexican mafia was out to get him. And
they were.
And how families rescue people who are trouble like this. And rescue them time and time and time again. Listen to the lyrics. The reasons as to why you've slipped back into addiction, but and I know you will slip back into addiction because I know you well.
Right.
I know you will because I know you well. Spare me the reasons, and yeah, you'll keep coming back because I know you well, and I'll keep taking you back because addiction. I wish you well.
It's addictive personalities.
It's addictive personalities. Or it's rescuing personalities from the rescuer's point of view in this song. Me the reason. So there's My Muse, a great song, and I'm kind of bummed that was never released as a single because I thought it had the legs to do so.
Really?
Yeah.
And I mean, I've heard that before, but I don't know that. Is it only that I've heard it on the album?
You've only heard it on the album.
On Alexa.
I don't believe that was ever released.
Can we say that, Amazon? Can I say Alexa? Can we refer to that?
Alexa, play Two Dudes Reviews on YouTube. We just pissed off everybody who's watching this thing when their Alexa pops up. The next track.
I didn't think about that.
Yeah. This one was a single, and when I first heard this one, I immediately hearkened back to a band called Monster Mag. You remember the song Space Lord?
No.
No? You never heard Space Lord? Okay, listen. I'm going to play this song for you.
Remember that I'm here to give the layman's perspective.
Right. Okay. Well, I'll play you Space Lord from Monster Magnet, and you're going to hear the beginning of Space Lord, and you're going to go, oh, wow, that sounds like Red Sun Rising. No. Red Sun Rising sounds like Space Lord, and it goes like this. It's Emotionless. Almost the exact same beginning with the guitar. And creepy as hell. Even creepier than this video of us two idiots sitting here in a room talking to ourselves.
I don't know this is creepy.
Keep it here forever, little one. And I feel good about you not selling anyone. You're just like motion. Again, so.
You know what? I mean, I listen to that. Who hasn't? I mean, what man hasn't laid in bed? I wake up earlier than my hot chick, Jill, almost every night we sleep together. And I do. You look over at them, and women are so beautiful when they sleep because there is that. It's emotionless, right? It's calm. It's peace.
Sometimes I wish my wife were that way.
Oh. So it's just me.
For whatever reason, I immediately think of the most negative thing I can about this song, about this weird possession thing. Like, I want to take in this woman, fill her with copious amounts of Rohibanol, and take advantage of her and put her in my closet and keep her like a blow-up doll.
Did I miss that part of the song?
I don't know, man.
I'm thinking about waking up in the morning and looking at my amazing hot chick Joe and going,
you're wow. so romantic.
Oh, dude.
I was told today, by the way, don't refer to the ladies in the videos as hot chicks because some of the females take offense to that.
Oh.
Instead, refer to them as beautiful, gorgeous women.
Beautiful, gorgeous women. Okay. Hey, if you're offended, I'm sorry.
Sorry.
But I'm not.
This song is called Blister. Think about Tonto riding off into the sunset on his horse. Whistle if you want to. This song really shows off Mike's lyrical ability just as far as his range. Shows and catacombs, injustices, a place on the glow. Point your finger and give it a spin now. Cause there's no end to this way. As long as there's blood on my hands. I'm thinking Brent Smith and Shinedown.
Right there especially.
Yeah. Symbols, brand, and segregate. Silver consequence. I hate to do this, but I really want to get to the point in the song here where he's just belting it out and really shows his shows his amazing range here. It's like the last. Let's see if I can find it. Maybe this is it right here, right after the guitar solo. He hits highs that most singers couldn't fathom hitting right here. A little Adam Lambert in there. If I'm going way back, I'm thinking maybe Ian Astbury from The Cult. And you mentioned somebody that they reminded you of earlier, which was Singer. Yeah, you said that they reminded you of the Stroke Me, Stroke
Billy
Me guy.
Billy Squire. Okay. So no, you can kind of almost hear a little Billy Squire in that. Bullshit. I was making a comment about how Mike's voice is really pure and really clean.
Uh-huh.
And
then he belts out those, like,
he pulls
those raspy
out and
there.
A little raspy, a little, you know, and we like that in rock and roll.
The name of that song was Blister, and now this is Worlds Away. Love the kind of backwards masking is what they call it, where the guitar is sound like it's in reverse.
But it's not.
Or sitar. It probably is in reverse, or it could be a weird effect they're using. We'd have to talk to Mike about that.
But he's the singer, not the guitarist.
You know, with a singer like Mike, I'm... He strikes me as somebody who would be the conductor behind the band, the guy who can probably play every bit of drum pieces that's on the record,
right.
Could probably nail all the guitar parts, tells the bass player, here's what you got to play. Who knows? I don't know the guys personally. Maybe that's not the case. Again, another one of these choruses is big and anthemic. It could certainly have been a single. Whether it would have done as well as The Other Side or Emotionless or Amnesia, I don't know.
Yeah, you know, I don't know that there's enough body, enough bottom end for me.
There's just something that seems a little missing on that song.
It's not quite, you know, single worthy in my opinion. But
okay.
Again, who the hell am I?
Well, you're just a layman.
I'm the other dude.
Let's go back to a Tonto then. You're the mountain.
You didn't tell me to bring a cowboy hat today.
I got a pair of boots right there. They're rattlesnake skin. You can bring them out if you want. Good song. I don't know that the chorus in this is something that I would that would hook me enough to. I don't know. Almost sounds like two songs in one.
It's what I was kind of reflecting just now on the how lyrical it is. Right. Mm-hmm. You've got all these other voices that come in and bring to it, and it has that heavier bass, little bottom line, a little heavier right. driving beat, and. That's kind of a song that I like, but I agree. Again, this wasn't a single, was it?
Yeah, no, it was not.
Wasn't a single.
Here's number 9. It's called Awake from Red Sun Rising. And this one, very staccato. Again, another one of those. It's just a little tough to get going for me. Love the wah-wah. Sure, a great song live in concert because it's heavy and punchy and right up in front. It's a Viking song. This is a song you could drive to, but we're 50 seconds into it, and it hasn't just
the hooked
me
not
yet.
There.
The hook's not the in hook's there not yet. There. Okay, so...
So again, you talk about, and now you make me think about why do you listen to an album, right? Mm-hmm. They can't all be hits.
Or, yeah.
Well, sometimes they can. I'm sure there's Prince albums that everything was a hit, right?
Well, but yeah, you got. I mean, look at AC/DC's Back in Black, or look at Pyromania from Def Leppard, what was the...
Anyway... Yeah. But the reality is that especially, you know, bands breaking out and all that sort of stuff, they can't all be hits. Mm-hmm. But it doesn't mean it's a bad song. It's something, again, this is something that I would drive to. I'd be driving, I'd be like, well, yeah, this is
just,
great.
Just digging it. But you wouldn't be able to recall, I love that song, Awake, right?
Right.
Just from listening to the song itself. This one is another very thoughtful, introspective song called Bliss from Polyester, Zeal, and Red Sun Rising. I feel like I should be whispering during this one. Interesting. The song is called Bliss.
You know what?
My bliss is ignorance.
This song, that acoustic song, right?
Right.
I look at that and I think about that and think, you know what? I'm a fan of acoustic music, and so I have to wonder, what does the whole album sound like acoustic?
Yeah.
What would it sound like if they were doing? Because I like a lot of the harder songs as an acoustic version.
And a lot of bands will reveal that their best music was started as an acoustic song.
Right.
You look at Alice in Chains Unplugged in New York City, bring back another Alice in Chains reference, or Nirvana Unplugged.
Yeah. Stained.
You know, yeah, and a lot of that stuff was written in the acoustic environment and translates so well in the acoustic environment.
Right.
This is the part of the program where we do product placement. The refreshments today brought to you by
Lining
Googles. This is the Canoe Paddler from Lining Googles. That'll be $200 hundo for each one of us. What do you think of that beer, anyways? We don't care. Let's move on to the next one.
It's not a beer review, dude.
This song is called Imitation The Rocker to wrap up the album from Red Sun Rising. Check it. Another Drummond. I got to pause this right here. That's the first of multiple times he says suicide. And this song is tough for me to listen to because he says suicide so many times. He says kill yourself so many times. And it took me a dozen times listening to this song before I really got the lyrics and went, oh, okay, I get it.
Be yourself.
Be yourself or you kill yourself. It's if you're it's kind of imitating extreme, isn't it? Everybody else through your entire life. And then you're pretty much committing soul suicide.
You know what? It's an old saying. Imitation is the
sincerest form of flattery, right?
Well, didn't we just sit here and go, sounds like Billy Squire. Sounds like Alice in Chains. Sounds like Maynard from Tool.
Yeah.
You know what? I think every artist copies from every other artist. Otherwise, you'd never get anything done.
There's got to be
something borrowed.
Yeah, we're a sum of the five bands we listen to most often. I don't know. Who knows?
Could be that.
By the way, the guys look like this.
Kind of like the Beatles.
Yeah. They look like a Muslim Beatles.
It's a very Beatle-esque drawing.
Yeah. If the Beatles were members of ISIS. Sorry, Red Sun Rising. We kid, man. We kid. Anyhow, the meaning behind the song is very, very positive. And it'll set you free.
But again, you until you know who you are,
which is how old are we, and we still don't really know for sure.
I think I might have figured out who it is, but I'm not sure yet. But ultimately, the only way to really know who you are is to kind of go through it, right? You imitate other people for a while, and then you realize, oh, that's not me, or that is me, or that's kind of how I am.
Yeah.
And you identify with people, so it might not be imitation; it's just identification.
Yeah. You know what? We're 22 minutes into this video here. We appreciate you for sticking around and checking it out. This is, without a doubt, one of the very few bands that I am so excited to hear what they're coming out with next. And I know that with the amount of time they've been on the road, that they've got quite a bit of catalog that's already written for a new album. And I just hope to God that they don't come up with a sophomore slump. I hope they can take it to the next level. And I mentioned this in the last video. By the way, this is the second time we've done this video. The first time it was just us talking to each other the whole time.
We're going
to
play that as a B-roll later or something. I don't know.
Because none of the music was playing down the line to the video. But I was mentioning how I've seen these guys play three different times, and the first time was great. The second time was amazing. The third time was the best I've heard them yet. It was at the end of a tour, after the end of a two-year run where they're playing four, five, six shows a week. And the singer, he was hitting notes that are even bigger and better than what was on the album. So I have a lot of faith that the Red Sun Rising will deliver big time on their next record.
Fantastic.
Go check it out. We've got chicken to go eat.
Chicken to eat?
It's two dudes reviews.
Until next time.